Hi, my name's Lauren Haley, and I'm a behavioral consultant with Brett DiNovi and Associates. Welcome back for our series going through the different compound schedules of reinforcement. To date, we've gone through concurrent schedules, multiple schedules, and chain schedules. Today, we're going to keep on rolling and go through the next two. So just as a refresher, a compound schedule refers to when a behavior analyst combines schedules of continuous reinforcement, intermittent reinforcement, differential reinforcement of various rates of responding, and extinction. Ferster and Skinner identified that elements of compound schedules can occur either together or apart, with or without discriminative stimuli to distinguish them, and as a reinforcement contingency independently, or a contingency formed by the combination of all elements. To review, as compound schedules, a concurrent schedule is one that combines two or more schedules of reinforcement to reinforce two or more types of behavior. These schedules are run simultaneously, meaning they occur at the same time. In the multiple and chains ones that we already went over, those two require specific discriminative stimuli that distinguish the different reinforcement contingencies from one another. Today, we're going to discuss the two different types of compound schedules that don't require discriminative stimuli. They're also called non-discriminative compound schedules. When we're thinking about these ones, keep in mind that the best way to remember these different types of compound schedules is to find ways to group them together based on their commonalities. So the same way that multiple and chain schedules go together, these next two are going to go together. So the first one we're going to review is a mixed schedule. A mixed schedule is identical to a multiple schedule, except that there aren't any discriminative stimuli used. That means that you're going to have at least two different basic schedules of reinforcement that are being run successively and in random order. Again, the only difference between a mixed schedule and a multiple schedule is that there are no discriminative stimuli to identify which schedule is running at any given time. In terms of applied research on mixed schedules of reinforcement, Hanley, Iwata, and Thompson conducted a study in 2001 to basically see what the best way to thin schedules of reinforcement was. They took three participants who had previously engaged in problem behaviors like self-injury and treated them with extinction and taught them functional communication to otherwise get their needs met. So AKA they used FCT, which is functional communication training. So what they did was they utilized a mixed schedule of reinforcement and a multiple schedule of reinforcement. So one without discriminative stimuli and one with discriminative stimuli to see which one would be best in thinning the schedule of reinforcement for these participants. Basically what the researchers found was that the multiple schedule was much more effective in maintaining low rates of problem behavior and also making sure that the alternative behavior response that was taught through FCT was maintained. Basically what they found was that when the mixed schedule was used, the participants' problem behavior, specifically their self-injury, reestablished itself and increased, and they saw a lot of decreased responding with their functional communication. So what they found was that using the multiple schedule really allowed more stimulus control and schedule control. The second type of compound schedule in this category is a tandem schedule. A tandem schedule is going to be identical in protocol to the chain schedule that we covered in the last video. Again, the only difference is going to be that there is not a discriminative stimuli that's distinguishing between the different elements of the schedule. For example, there may be two basic schedules working successively in the same order each time, but there isn't actually anything that signals to the organism that the schedule's changing at any given time as the procedure goes on. An important thing to note about mixed schedules and tandem schedules is that the reality is that antecedent stimuli play a large, large role in our everyday life. So it's pretty infrequent that you're going to have behaviors maintained every day that don't have discriminative stimuli signaling when contingencies change. So even though there's little applied application at this time, there is considerable data about the effects of these different schedules, the mixed and the tandem schedules, on behavior. So eventually the hope is that applied research will be able to take this data and apply it to their practices every day with individuals. So far in this video series, we have reviewed five of the seven types of compound schedules. In our last video, we'll round it out and cover the last two. In the meantime, if you have any questions or comments about the ones we've covered so far, please put them in the section below.